our first sleepover that weekend, so I guess now I have to ask Stephen for permission for a sleepover. But she's the best friend I've ever had, and I thank God it. Sorry. I thank God every day that she's my friend. I said I wasn't going to cry, I made it to her. Anyways, I know that they're perfect for each other, and I can't wait to see what else they have in store for each other.
Good evening, everyone. My name is David. I'm the best man, although I assume there are much better men here tonight who could be saying something. But I am just so honored and so humbled to be here at Stephen's wedding, to be a part of a milestone in his life. Stephen and I, we go way back. We grew up in Costa Rica together. And we didn't start out as friends, not even remotely, and I felt like I had to share that, but we've really warmed up to one another, and I've shared some incredible experiences with Stephen, and so much so that even after several years of not even seeing him, not spending much time with him, I still feel this draw and this desire to support him and to be a part of his life. And there is a bond that I have with Stephen that I can't describe, but it's really just been formed over so many years of being close friends. And I'm just so grateful that I can be here to support you and Kelsey as you enter into a new stage of life together. So there are only a couple things that I wanted to share, but what I wanted to talk about was kind of like the theme of what I want to say is common denominator. So what I did is I just asked the bridesmaids and several people just to give me some adjectives to describe Stephen and Kelsey. So why don't I just read them? So I won't necessarily say who these are for. You just accept them. Okay. I have loyalty. I have friendship. I have loving. I have listener. This one, you wouldn't know this one, but she always agrees with me when I complain about some guy. We are sisters. I have good listener again. I have responsible. And I have loyal. I have patient. I have kind. I have beautiful. I have handsome. And some others you don't need to know. What I wanted to talk about was, for both of these incredible individuals, for those of these close friends of mine, there were a couple that overlapped. There was loyalty, there was friendship, there was loving, there was listening. And I know you two are different, and I know there are a lot of things that make you individuals, but there are some things that are the common denominator, and that is loyalty, and being able to listen, and being loving. And when we talk about common denominator, I think it's those qualities that is going to keep them together. It's going to be sort of a foundation that even though there are different characteristics that accentuate who they are as individuals, when it comes down to the very basics, they are going to be loyal to one another, and they are going to listen to one another and love one another. I also wanted to share just three words with you tonight, specifically to Stephen and Kelsey. These three words, I have it on all my notes here. I didn't want to forget. I have family, I have fragrance, and I have future. The reason I chose those three words are because, one, family, that is what we're seeing right here, are the beginnings of a family. And that is a common denominator for people and for society. And we're looking at the beginnings of a very strong family, if it's based on loyalty and loving and listening. The second word that I have is fragrant, and I know both of you smell good tonight, but that's not what I'm referring to. This is a verse that I actually really paid attention to after my sister shared it, So I'm just going to read it to you all tonight. It says, but thanks be to God who always leads us in triumphal procession in Christ and who makes known through us the fragrance that consists of the knowledge of him in every place. That's 2 Corinthians 2:14. And I chose fragrance because, one, we all have the ability to share the word of God and to love other and to spread this fragrance of Christ. But when we're united as a couple, as a duo, as a tag team, we're all the more efficient. And I just wanted to encourage you, to remind you what the purpose of marriage is. It's to spread the knowledge of Christ, the fragrance of him everywhere, wherever we need to go. And the last word that I wanted to share was future. There is no future without the former two words. There is no future without family, without loving Christ and putting him first and foremost. And there is no future unless we dedicate our lives to spreading the fragrance of him everywhere. Again, I just am so glad to be here. Stephen is part of my family, and he always will be. So.